they specifically wanted Jairo and I notice. Even though police report said that it was just random assault, we know the people who did this. I had problem with them last year during the whole season because they were very aggressive poachers. We knew that they were armed. We knew the way they worked, and they really, really had a thing. You know, they really wanted to get us.
Jairo Mora Sandoval apareció muerto el 31 de mayo anterior en Playa Moín, en Limón, cuando realizaba un patrullaje para cuidar huevos.
Sobre este tema, el Ministerio de Ambiente y Energía avanza en la creación de un área protegida en Moín que llevaría el nombre de Jairo Mora.
Ambientalistas están claros de que se está tratando de un homicidio porque, de acuerdo con la ventana de colegar, hay aspiración de
arena. Además, se maneja la posibilidad de crear un área protegida en la zona, o bien modificar el nombre del refugio Gandoca Manzanillo y agregar...
Los testimonios de las dos extranjeras que lo acompañaban y las pertenencias de Jairo...
El turismo en Limón está afectando la economía de Limón, afecta a las poblaciones afectadas de Limón, afecta a grandes.
He was not supposed to go out because during those nights it had become quite dangerous for us to go out. I knew people wanted to kill him and me. Jairo was killed because he actually, during some time that he was with them, he tried to protect the girls. He ran back to see if they were safe, and as he was running back, he got a big bump in the head with a shovel or a piece of wood. We still don't know what it was. By the other guys that were coming back. So I know that's why he didn't escape from the ice, because if he wanted to, he would have. He knew how to swim. He would have just go into the ocean and get lost. It was pretty easy for us that if we knew the beach, we could have, you know, just hide. But I know his priority was saving the girls.
He knew those men were dangerous.
Yeah, he knew. Yeah, we knew.
Yeah, I think that he will never be forgotten because of that, because his friends know that that was him. He wasn't going to back down. He was proud of what he was doing, and he wasn't going to let it go. But having it be someone like Jairo just made it so real and so upsetting, just that there were so many warning signs and he asked for help and everyone was so aware of how dangerous it was and no one did anything about it. And I honestly, I'm sad to say that I don't think, it's not the first time and it won't be the last that something like that will happen. And that's really difficult.
Sí, fue impactante porque compartimos casi por 6 años el trabajo, además que adquirí conocimiento de él. Él explicaba a uno cómo era y el trabajo y el protocolo de todo el proyecto. Era buen compañero y la reacción que yo tomé fue muy triste en realidad. Me impactó mucho. Para mí fue dolorosa. Porque él lo recibíamos este año, en esta temporada de Baula, que inicia ahora en noviembre. Él estuviese acá hoy en día con nosotros también, trabajando juntos. Difícil.
It's Costa Rica, and we're supposed to be one of the greenest countries ever. However, I think we're selling ourselves to big companies that pretty much can destroy nature.
No matter how much this might bring attention to certain things, it's already been put on the back burner, and the issues are so deeply rooted and so, there's so much corruption that there's just no, there's no easy way out, and there's nothing on a personal level that I can do to make a difference there. It's scary to realize that there are some places in the world that are still like that, where it's literally life and death.
Con baulas y negras que están en muy peligro de extinción, y siento que es muy importante inculcar a las personas que vienen el trabajo importante que estamos haciendo ahorita.
In vain, and the government has a responsibility, and they need to answer fast.